So just to go to the back to the diagram, what we just saw was exactly an example of this general outline that I showed you. So CSmith was the random test case generator. It was given seeds by a driver script. The driver script ran the tools in a loop, and the oracle in this case was just simply looking for compiler crashes. So it wasn't even running the compiler output. So of course, when a compiler runs, it generates code. We weren't even running that code or even looking at it. All we were doing is waiting for the compiler to tell us that it failed. And the reason the compiler could tell us that it failed is because the compiler developers had conveniently included lots of assertion violations. If those compiler developers hadn't included all of those assertions, then these compilers wouldn't have failed in such an obvious way. But they still had encountered bugs, and they probably would have failed in different ways later, and they might have failed in the worst possible way, which is where the compiler generates code, and that code actually executes improperly at runtime. And that's bad because we, as compiler consumers, don't want the compiler giving us wrong code. So while those assertions can be annoying as compiler users because the compiler crashes, they're actually very good, and we want them to be there. So the driver scripts are then checking the output, saving the test cases, or in this case, the seed in a log file, and then they go back and do it again. And so if you remember, in about 2 days of testing time, this loop had executed about 150,000 times on a fast 8-core machine. And of course, if we were testing simpler systems than compilers, we might have executed a much larger number of tests than that. And if we're executing very slow software under test, then we might have only executed a much smaller number of iterations.